Lakhani ji, Hinduism seems to believe too much into astrology. What is your opinion about astrology? Is it a proper science, or our belief in astrology is too much?
Okay. You see, I'm going to get a lot of stick for answering this question, but I'll give you my honest answer. And I'm ready for I keep getting stick anyway, so I'm used to it. I'm beaten up quite often. First of all, there was actually research conducted in ancient India over hundreds of years, where they looked at the stellar constellation, all the position of planets, and tried to see if they can interrelate it with the lives led by people born under certain horoscope. So they did research actually over a few hundred years. This is serious. That is how they created the horoscopes. Now the thing is this: it simply shows there is some kind of correlation between the position of stars and the way human beings kind of unfold, in their lives. There's some kind of correlation. You can't call it scientific. It just says by chance there is some correlation. Okay. So far so good. But then the issue is this: the moment you say my lives are controlled by the position of the planets, those rocks floating in the sky, that means you lost your dignity as a spiritual being. That means you are at the mercy of these rocks floating in the sky. The moment you do that, then you see you lost the dignity that that is your natural kind of inheritance. So I'm saying don't listen to all this. In fact, my mentor Vivekananda said, look, suppose somebody says you're going to die after 2 years, you start crying now. And somebody says you're going to win the lottery, you stop earning money. So it's best to ignore it, right or wrong. Just ignore it. There is a small possibility there is some correlation, I'll be very honest. But don't rely on it. Stand on your own feet and sort yourself out. Don't wait for your stars or your planets to sort you out. That is really losing your dignity. You are in command of your life. So stand up and sort yourself rather than wait for some stars, some planetary position. That's one. The second thing is this. When I see some of these, astrologers or palmists, etc., giving this resolution of how to solve your problem because Shani is in the wrong position and you have to sort it out. And I look at the answer they give is very frightening. They say, oh, wear this particular ring, with this opal, etc., this must be purple or whatever. Mm. I say, I'm asking myself, if I'm a rational being, suppose the planets are actually influencing me, how will this little thing stop it influencing my life? How can this possibly, I'm just asking, using my rational faculty, say, how can this possibly, this pendants, etc., solve my problem? So the fact they are just trying to fob you off, saying, oh, you've got problems, don't worry. Just wear this pendant and we'll tell you where to buy it from, etc. That worries me. Because that means you are really not. If suppose there is a resolution, then tell me how it works. What is the mechanism whereby huge planets' influence is kind of stopped by the little thing that you're wearing on your finger? I have no answer, so I'd rather keep away from it. I'll get a lot of stick for saying things so bluntly, but so be it, because the Hindus are so much, kind of wallowing in superstitions. It's necessary to ask them to grow up. Even if it is right, why do you want to be dictated by it? You show your dignity, saying, no, I'm going to stand up against them. You know what Vivekananda said? He said, if the planets are going to dictate my life, I'm going to shift those planets. Whether it succeeds or not, that's the spirit. That's called the spirit. You don't say, I'm not being by some rocks are dictating my life. How dare they? So stand up against it. That is the answer that we should use. Move away, grow up from that.